a dead-end tunnel where Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is said to have detonated a suicide vest and killed himself as Navy SEALs closed in on him. It came almost 5 years after ISIS executed North Central High School and Butler University alumni Peter Kasich. He changed his name to Abdul-Rahman while in captivity in the Syrian desert. Kasich was caught between the civilians he was trying to feed and nurture as an aid worker and the terrorists who reveled in videotaping their murders of Westerners.
As a Hoosier, I will tell you that I remember when Peter Kasich was killed. It broke the heart of the people of Indiana.
At the time, Kasich's parents were eloquent in their grief.
Greater love hath no man than this, than to lay down his life for another.
He has chosen to believe in the good, in himself and in others. Peter's life is evidence that he has been right all along. One person makes a difference.
During his captivity, Abdul-Rahman wrote this to his family, quote, "If I do die, I figure that at least you and I can seek refuge and comfort in knowing that I went out as a result of trying to alleviate suffering and helping those in need. We pray, especially today, that all those who are affected by warfare and hate may find light. Haste the day when swords shall be beaten into plowshares and spears into pruning hooks." Congressman Andre Carson wrote today, quote, "The death of ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is welcome news for all who have been threatened, terrorized, and harmed by his heinous actions." In November of 2014, several local representatives of Indianapolis-based Muslim organizations expressed their sorrow at Kasich's death. They and the Kasichs were not available for comment today. In the newsroom, Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.
And if you want to